Hey, welcome back to the channel. So recently I did a video of using an external GPU with an older Mac. And in that video, I asked if anybody wanted to see some benchmarking comparisons of the integrated GPU with the eGPU, and a bunch of you said you did. So that's what this video is all about. In this video, I'm gonna be using that 2014 Mac Mini that I used in the other videos. I'll put a link up here if you wanna see those. I'm also using a Radeon RX 470 video card in that Sonnet eGPU enclosure that I have. I'll have links down in the description to all the stuff that I talk about. And if you have any questions or comments as I go along, please feel free to leave those in the comment section. I try to answer all my comments. With all that out of the way, let's jump right into it. All right, so the first thing I want to talk about is the synthetic benchmarking, and I started this section with Geekbench. Now, Geekbench lets you test the CPU or the GPU. I didn't test the CPU because that's not changing, so I only did the OpenCL GPU test, and there was quite a difference. With the integrated GPU on this 2014 Mac Mini, we got a score of 19,115, which is kind of low. But using that RX 470 with that external GPU, we got a score of 111,299. So that is a massive difference. Again, this is just a synthetic benchmarking, but you can see how much more powerful this eGPU setup is than just using the integrated graphics. Next up is Cinebench, and as expected, there was no difference with the CPU, but the GPU with the OpenGL was quite a difference. With the integrated graphics on the OpenGL score, we got a score of 24.29 frames per second. And then with the RX 470 external GPU, we got a score of 62.41 frames per second. Huge difference right there. And this is kind of an indicator of what we're gonna see when we talk about the game section as well. So the next graphic test I did was Unigine Heaven, and I started off on the low setting. I only tested the integrated GPU on low because anything higher than that was pointless. And with that low setting, we got an average frame rate of 19 frames per second. Now switching over to the external GPU on low, we got an average frame rate of 93.9 frames per second. So basically 94 frames per second. I bumped that up to the high setting in Unigine Heaven, and we were still getting an average of 50.6 frames per second. Again, massive increase, even though this is only Thunderbolt 2, we're not using that graphics card to the full potential, it's still a significant increase over that integrated video card. All right, next up is the gaming section, and I tested three games. I tested 7 Days to Die, Shadow of Mordor, and Mad Max. Didn't do Fortnite. You'll be able to figure out if Fortnite's gonna perform better from these other results. So the first thing we did was 7 Days to Die. Now, this game does not run very well on Mac anyway, and with that integrated GPU with everything on low at 720p, we were getting a frame rate of 13 frames per second, so completely unplayable. Using the external GPU, bumping it up to 1080p, and increasing the video quality to medium, we were getting a solid 30 frames per second playing this game. That can be tweaked more. This is just with the default settings, and I think I turned motion blur off. But other than that, default medium settings, 30 frames per second versus 13 on the low settings for the integrated video card. So for these next two games, as soon as I launched them on the Mac Mini with the integrated GPU, I was greeted with a message that said the machine didn't meet the minimum specifications, but I tried it anyway. And on Shadow of Mordor at 720p, everything set on the lowest settings, 13 frames per second, just like 7 Days to Die, totally unplayable. Using that external GPU, bumping it up to 1080p and setting the default settings on high, I was getting right around 35 frames per second. It was a little bit higher and lower at times, but it averaged out to 35 frames per second. That's a totally playable frame rate. You can even increase that a little bit by messing with the settings. This was just the default settings. Next up is Mad Max. And like I said, I initially got that message about it not being compatible. I tried it anyway, and guess what? 13 frames per second. I see a theme here. It was on low, 720p, 13 frames per second with the integrated GPU. Using the external GPU, bumping everything up to 1080p and keeping the graphic settings at about medium, I was getting right around 30 frames per second. Again, a playable frame rate as opposed to 13 frames per second, completely unplayable. So I know 30 frames per second is not that great, but you got to keep in mind this is a 2014 Mac Mini with a dual core mobile CPU in it. So being able to play these games as well as I did was pretty impressive. And again, you'd be able to get much better frame rates out of this by tweaking those settings. I just used the default settings as they were. All right, so the last thing I'm gonna talk about is video editing. And although I'm specifically talking about video editing, this is gonna equate to graphic design and 3D editing and all that kind of stuff too. The performance gains that we see here are going to translate pretty well over to that other stuff. So using DaVinci Resolve with the integrated GPU was completely unusable, very slow, playback was horrible. I didn't even bother capturing video. Using the external GPU with DaVinci Resolve, it took full advantage of it and it worked great. I was able to load my 4K MP4s in there, scrub, playback at full speed, add transitions, effects, color correction, overlay text, all that stuff worked extremely, extremely well. In fact, it worked pretty much as well on this machine as it does on my Coffee Lake machine that I have with the GTX 1070 in it. I do know that DaVinci Resolve is much better optimized on Mac than the Windows version is, so that may have something to do with it, but this external GPU made a huge difference with DaVinci Resolve. Took it from being completely unusable to working really, really well. So next is Final Cut Pro, and Final Cut Pro actually works pretty well with this integrated GPU all by itself. On this machine, I can edit 4K video with no problem as long as the timeline is really simple. If I start adding effects, layering text, stuff like that, it really bogs down. With the external GPU, it worked even better, and I could add much more layers, make the timeline much larger than I could with that integrated GPU before I saw any slowdowns. If you're going to use Final Cut Pro with an external GPU, there's a setting. If you go to Get Info, you can check Prefer External GPU. That'll kind of force it to use that external GPU, and it works beautifully. So the next test I did in Final Cut Pro is the export test, and I used the Bruce X benchmark on this with the integrated GPU that took 2 minutes and 9 seconds to complete. Using that external GPU and forcing it to use that through that setting I just mentioned brought it down to 39 seconds. So it went from 2 minutes and 9 seconds down to 39 seconds. So massive, massive difference with Final Cut Pro using that external GPU, just like we saw with DaVinci Resolve. All right, so there we go. I don't really have a whole lot to say because that comparison pretty much speaks for itself. If you have an older Mac and you're looking for a way to up the graphical performance, an external GPU is a fantastic way to go, even with the Thunderbolt 2. If you have Thunderbolt 3, it's going to be even better because you'll be able to use that full bandwidth there. But even with the Thunderbolt 2, you can see how much of a difference that makes. If you're somebody that's gaming or doing media creation of basically any kind, an external GPU is going to be a massive increase for you. If you're somebody that's just browsing the web, checking your email and stuff like that, this is a pointless upgrade. It's not really going to improve anything. But for those other people that need that extra GPU horsepower, this is a great way to get that on your older Mac without having to buy a whole new machine. Hopefully you found this useful and informative. If you did, please hit that thumbs up. If you really liked it and you haven't subscribed yet, please consider subscribing and come see me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. I love meeting new people there and chatting with them, and I'll see you in the next video.